Bonjour, bonjour everyone. Welcome or welcome back. I hope you are doing good. My name is Cyril. I have been a stem cell researcher for quite some time. And my dog is Guabao. He's a beautiful French bulldog. He's almost 5 months. And as you can see, he starts to sleep in my arms. This is so cute. And for today's video, I'm going to do the formula breakdown of a new product from Niod, which is the copper amino isolate lipid 1%. And you will see that it is a very innovative and very interesting product, that it is very pricey though. So Niod is one of the brands that is owned by DCRM. I've been the first time that I've discovered Niod was thanks to Wayne Goss. He's a makeup artist, and I remember that he was trying the vitamin C serum, which is actually a derivative of vitamin C, which is the 3-O-ethyl-L-ascorbic acid, which features 30% of this ingredient. And at that time point, there were not a lot of scientific literature about this ingredient. There are still not a lot, I have to say, but in my own experience, this is a beautiful skin brightening ingredient. Anyway, Niod is a very, I would say, innovative skincare brand, and they are definitely doing things that are not done by other brands. And this product is also not an exception. It is a very, I would say, interesting formula. So if you are like a really nerdy, I would say, like I am, about skincare ingredient, this is definitely an interesting ingredient to look at. So this product features copper peptides. So, and exactly, it contains a modified version of the copper peptide, because the copper peptide has been coupled with a palmitate group. A palmitate group is a lipophilic group. So what does it mean? It means that palmitate is soluble in fat, in lipids, and the whole idea to attach it to the copper peptide is to make the peptides more soluble in the skin, aka to pass it through the skin barrier. And why this is an interesting and cool feature is because there are a lot of scientific data. Most of them were done only in vitro about copper peptide, that shows that it can promote collagen synthesis, especially when it was added to fibroblasts. Fibroblasts are the cell that you have in the dermis that produce the collagen, the hyaluronic acid, the elastin, and all the good stuff that we have in the dermis. But if the copper peptide cannot go into the dermis, it is pretty useless. So copper peptide has been discovered in 1973 by Laurent Picard, and since then they have like a pretty nice paper that has been published on it, and they all show that this peptide, first of all, naturally occurs in our body. So we find it in our blood, we also find it in our saliva, but also in our skin. So this is an interesting feature. So this is a mimicking ingredient, which I am definitely all about. What is also very interesting is that while we age, we have twice as less at this peptide in our blood. So someone who is 60 years old has twice as less as this copper peptide compared to someone who is 20 years old. So it definitely makes sense to use this copper peptide in an anti-aging cream or serum. So like I said, there are some really nice work that has been done on this peptide to show that it helps to heal the skin, that it is anti-inflammatory, that it is potentially anti-aging in the sense that it can promote collagen synthesis. And what is also excellent about this ingredient is that we do have some in vivo experiments, so basically work that has been done on us versus placebo to show that the anti-aging effect, and some of them demonstrate that it does promote collagen synthesis in their dermis, which is excellent. Unfortunately, those papers are not really easy to read. I have tried to find them, but I could not. And also compared to the gold standard molecule, which is in over-the-counter skincare ingredient, which is retinol. If you are not new to my channel, you will know that I talk a lot about retinol. Or if you want to have an even stronger retinoid, go straight away to see your dermatologist to have retinoic acid, also known as tretinoin. In all the peptides that we have currently in the market, this is definitely the one to get, and that has, I would say, the most literature about. So the copper peptide that Niod is using in this one is named palmitoyl tripeptide 1 copper. So it is different from the one that you also find in the other peptide serum that I've tried, and that is also an excellent one. It is still very pricey, but a very, I would say, interesting formula. But the form of this peptide is slightly different because, like I said, it has a palmitate form. It is very reminiscent from the peptide that you also find in the matrix cell 3000, which is two peptides that are cell, and it is also the palmitoyl 2 peptide 1. But the difference is that the one from NIOD, they also have the copper. So I would imagine that the results are even better than the other one, so the one without the palmitoyl group, but I didn't find any scientific literature on this one, but it is very interesting. So I don't have any scientific data to show you that this form of the copper peptide is better than the other one. So for sure, from scratch, if I have to choose between the KL 1%, so this one, versus their serum, I will go first with the serum. Obviously, if you are a skincare nerd and if you are willing to invest in them, I would buy both of them. What is also different about this formula is that, first of all, this is not a serum, and this is mainly a lipid-based product. By lipid, I mean a sort of oil-based products. So the first emollient that you are going to find here is squalane. Squalane is a natural lipid that you find in the skin that is produced by our keratinocyte, and that is one of the key lipids from our skin barrier. We also find free fatty acids. Again, they are naturally occurring in our skin in the form of caprylic capri triglycerides. We also find glycolipids that are very interesting. There are not that many scientific data on them, but glycolipids are basically lipids that are linked to our sugar, and they can also act as emulsifying ingredient, because a sugar likes water, a lipids like fat, so it can bond water content plus lipidic content, and basically that's it. But what you need to remember that the squalane and the free fatty acid are like the two first ingredients, so this is mainly an oil-based product. In terms of humectant, you have glycerin. I love glycerin, it is one of the best. There is also hydrogenated starch, which are basically sugar derived from corn. And the last one is propanidol that you also find, I would say, quite often in skincare. So I always like when a formula has a balance between emollients and humectants. Obviously, just by looking at the formula, this is mainly an oil-based serum. Therefore, if you're willing to try it, I would add it just after my moisturizer. There are also other anti-aging ingredients. So the first one is the one that I've already talked about. This is the palmitoyl copper peptide, obviously. There is also hydroxymethoxyphenylpropylmethoxybenzofuran, so such a long molecule, so such a long name, that is sold as SIM3D. This one is also supposed to be an anti-aging ingredient. And we also have an extract from vetiver that is supposed to be antioxidants. Again, with this one, there are not that many scientific literature. I would avoid those ingredients and replace it by peptides, for example, or simply by retinol. Last but not least, we have another ingredient, which is aphanizomenon plus aquare extract, which is basically the name for a microalgae, which is a cyanobacteria. So something that I found so interesting about cyanobacteria is that they are the first life form that we have discovered on planet Earth. And those cyanobacteria are thought to be the first organism to have produced the oxygen that we currently have in our atmosphere. So they are an interesting ingredient in the sense that they have a lot of complex sugar, also peptides, and some interesting lipids. I didn't see any major scientific reports on them, so this is again a new ingredient with not a lot of scientific data, but still it is interesting. And this one is also almost never found. So overall, when you look at the formula, this is definitely something that you I've never seen. So do I recommend to invest in it? Because it costs $90 for only 15 ml, so a little bit for a very high price. Definitely because it is so original, so different, and because they also use a different form of the copper peptide, which is the one with the palmitoyl group. In a way, it sort of justifies the price. Now, is it something that it is a staple that you really need to invest into your skincare routine? The answer is no. If you are into really skincare, you love to layer, you really want to have like the last innovation, this is definitely one product that I would try. And like I said, because it is a lipid-based product, I would add it only at the end of the formula. I would not use it on the own. I would use this one in conjunction with the peptide serum from NIOD, definitely. And I would also add retinol, and I would use them only at night. So So comment down below and tell me if you are ready to break the bank to try this product. If you like this video, please thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to ring the bell to not miss any of my new videos. You can also follow me on Instagram. I am Cyril Laurent. I thank you so much for watching me, and I will see you next time with my dog. Au revoir, bye bye.